This is the Ibanez SR300E in Shoreline Metallic Burst. And right away, tell me that this doesn't look amazing. For just over 200 quid, you can get something that looks this good and does this much stuff, which we'll get into in a second, for that price. It's crazy. Ibanez have kind of been modifying the bass guitar for the past 30, 40 years, coming on leaps and bounds with every new product lineup they have. The SR300 range has been out for quite some time, and there's a reason for that. They're bloody good. You can get pretty much every single sound out of this bass. It's got two PowerSpan Dual Coil humbucking pickups. They are passive, but there's an active three-band EQ. Bass, middle, and treble. They're notched in the middle as well, so when it's in the middle, it's totally flat. You can either cut or boost each of those lovely frequencies. There's a volume control and a pickup balancer, so instead of a switch going between the neck, middle, and, well, the neck and bridge, you kind of blend the two. Very, very funky. This switch here is a power tap switch. When it's up on the top, you're only using one of the coils to get a lovely spanky sound. In the middle, it's dual like a normal humbucker. And at the bottom, it's power tap. It's kind of Ibanez's own thing. It's a mix between the two. It's nice and spanky, but nice and full sounding. It's got mahogany body, a lovely five-piece maple and rosewood neck, rosewood fingerboard, lovely, lovely thin neck. You can get up and down this neck, no problem at all. It's lovely and light. The top horn here sticks out nice as well, so there's no neck drop or anything like that. Yeah, a nice modern spin on the bass guitar. Let's have some more sounds. So like I said, you can get pretty much every conceivable sound out of these Ibanez basses. They're used by a variety of artists such as Gary Willis, Thundercat, Stephen Brunner, and metal guys like Fieldy from Korn and Paul Gray, who was in Slipknot. So the EQ is now flat, both pickups are on. I'll show you what this power tap switch does. In the up position, like I said, the coils are tapped, so only one of each of them are firing to get a lovely spanky sound. Both them on in the middle. Comparison. And power tap is a mixture of the two, the best qualities of both. It sounds absolutely banging in the power tap mode, so I'm gonna leave it on that for the rest of the little review. I'll show you the pickups now. Let's roll on back to the bridge pickup. You can blend up to the neck pickup. And send them both together. Boost some of the mids and some of the bass. Running quite hot there. Let's bring some of that bass down, put some treble in, so it's boosting the treble and the mids. Sounds pretty cool, nice and squawky. Let's cut that and boost the bass as well. Playability wise, it's a beautiful thing. Satin maple and rosewood neck, like I said. It just fits in your hand beautifully. You get all access to all 24 frets. That's two octaves. It's quite resonant as well due to the big Ibanez high mass bridge and the mahogany body. It plays as good as it looks. Look at it, man. It's mental. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool music, guitar, bass related content. If you want any more info on this guy or any Ibanez bass, go to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding beautiful PMT stores. Each one of our lovely stores has its own Twitter, Instagram and Facebook page. Be sure to like your local one or them all if you're feeling that nice. I've been Dagan and I grew up next to the seaside, so this is kind of my thing. I'll see you next time.